In this video, we'll talk about what is a subquery, what are correlated queries, and what's the difference between subquery and correlated queries. So first, let's start with subquery. Subquery is also termed as nested queries. Subquery is nothing but it's a query inside a query. Many times, you know, you'd like to have series of SQL chained, you know, where output of one query is sent as an input to the other query for filtering and manipulation. For example, you can see in the figure, you know, we have two tables. One table has the employee salary and the second table has phone numbers. Now, let's say that we want to find phone numbers of employees, who have salaries, you know, which are greater than 150. Now, this can be achieved by using subquery. So what we can do is we'll have two queries. One is the inner query, which will go and fetch, records, you know, which are greater than 150. And the output of this will be feeded to an outer query who will go and fetch the phone numbers. So first thing is, first we'll go and select. So let's go and query the EMP SAL table. So we'll say, okay, select ID from EMP SAL where salary is greater than 150. So this will be our inner query. Now the output of this inner query will be fed to a query which is an outer query, which will actually go and extract phone number. So what I'll do is I'll say, okay, this is my inner query, okay, and the output of this inner query will now be sent to an outer query. So this is our outer query. Select star from EMP details. Let's go and expand this bit. Where ID in. Okay. Just let me go and indent this so that everybody can see it properly. Also, there's a red sign here. So this is actually IDFK. Okay. So IDFK. Right. So now you can see that, you know, what will happen is first the inner query will evaluate himself. He will extract records, you know, whose salary is greater than 150. Those IDs will then be fed to this outer query who will say, okay, IDs, you know, which are been supplied by this inner query, you know, I'll go and extract the EMP details out of it. Okay. So let me just go and comment this. So you can see now this is the outer query and this is the inner query. So if I go and execute this, you can see now he is showing me phone numbers as well as address, you know, of employees whose salaries are greater than 150. So if just to go and recheck this, if this is proper or not, if I go and execute this, you can see that we have two employees here whose salaries are greater than 150. One is XYZ and other one is Srini. So 3 and 4. So if I go and fire this SQL again, we can see that he has selected those third and the fourth record and he has taken the phone numbers and address out of it. So this is what a subquery is. A subquery is nothing but it's a query inside query. So we have an inner query. So first the inner query gets evaluated. The data from the inner query is then supplied to the outer query and the complete data is then displayed, or the complete output is then displayed. So this was about subquery. Now there is one more thing which we'll discuss in this video is correlated queries. So let me just go and delete all this. Now let's take a situation where you want to go and find the second highest from this table, EMP SAL. So how will you go about doing that? Now this can be achieved by using correlated query. So what I'll do is, first let me go and write down the correlated query here and then I'll explain how exactly it operates. So I'm going to go and paste this correlated query here. And let me first explain you this SQL and then we will go about executing this. Now the first thing which you will notice is that there is an inner query and then there is an outer query. So you can think about that, you know, correlated queries are a type of variation of subquery or nested queries. So one similarity between both of them is, you know, that both have an inner query and both have an outer query. But, you know, there is a big difference in the way the data is passed between inner query and outer query. So let me explain that. So you can see here that, you know, your inner query is also referencing the outer query table. So you can see that I have the EMP SAL table, right? I have defined two aliases here. You can see I'm saying EMP SAL E1, which is referenced in the outer query. And then we have EMP SAL E2, which is again referenced in the inner query. And you can see here that I am saying that e2.salary should be greater than e1.salary. In other words, you know, my inner query is referencing the outer query. If you remember in subquery, right, you know, there were no references. So the you can think about that in subquery, right, the inner query was completely independent and standalone. But here you can see that, you know, there is a relation between the inner query and outer query. Actually, the inner query is referencing the outer query table. That's why the name is correlated queries. So here's how this thing will work. So what happens here is the outer query record is passed to the inner query. The inner query, you know, evaluates that record and passes the data again back to the outer query. So here's how it works. So first thing, it goes record by record. So first shiv will be taken. Okay. And from the outer query, the shiv record will be passed to the inner query. In the inner query, we say that, okay, how many salaries are greater than and equal to shiv? That is 100. So we have 1, 2, 3. Okay. And also equal to 100. So again, you know, we have even shiv included in that. So 4. Okay. So we say, okay, we want to find the second highest here. Now we are trying to find the second highest. Okay. Second highest. So when the shiv record is passed to the inner query, he will say, okay, it will actually give out a count of 4 and this is not equal to 2. Okay. So that record will be eradicated. Then it will take the second one, Raju. Now Raju 150 will be again passed to the inner query. The output will be 1, 2, 3. Again, it is not the second highest. After that, XYZ will be taken. Again, it will be passed to the inner query. Now we'll say, okay, how many records are greater than 200 or equal to 200? So we have 1, 300 and he himself. So that is equal to 2. And this is the second highest. So in other words, every record from the outer query is passed to the inner query. The inner query then again evaluates it. And then again, it is passed to the outer query. So if I go and execute this now, you can see that he is displaying XYZ, which is actually the second highest salary. So now let's summarize, you know, what exactly is a subquery and what exactly is a correlated query. And also let's try to point out the important differences between them. In subquery, right, the inner query is independent. It is self-contained and it gets evaluated first, and then the complete record is passed, you know, to the outer query and the data is displayed after that. While in correlated queries, right, the inner query needs the values from the outer query. And then, you know, these results are passed back to the outer query. So you can think about in subquery, you know, it's more of a unidirectional thing, you know, where the data just moves from the inner query to the outer query. While in correlated queries, right, the data moves to and fro, and then finally the final output is displayed, you know, after it matches the where clause. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand what exactly is a subquery, what exactly is a correlated query, and what are the important differences between them. Thank you so much. Now, whatever video you have seen, right, is just a glimpse of what we have done. So in case you are interested in our video package, you can go to our site, that is www.questpond.com. You can call on this number and you can ask the complete DVD package what we have. So in this DVD package, what we have done is basically we have covered almost everything what a .NET developer wants. So right from basics of ASP.NET, object-oriented programming, SQL Server, to new technologies like WCF, Silverlight, Link, Azure, Entity Framework. We also have UML, architecture, estimation, project management. There is a complete invoicing project end-to-end which is covered, so that you can get a better feel of how to actually create projects in a systematic manner. We have covered server products, you know, both for SharePoint 2007 as well as for 2010. We have a lot of best practices video on SQL Server, etc. So this complete package, you know, you can get from www.questpond.com if you're interested. And you can call on this number and you can ask for the rates. It's a very decent rate what we have. In the same way, you know, as compared to the videos, we also have one more product with us, that is our interview question books. So we have different kinds of interview question books, you know, right from .NET interview questions to SQL Server interview questions, SharePoint interview questions, BizTalk interview questions, etc. So in case you are interested in the books part, you can call on these numbers as per your location. So you can see these numbers on the board at this moment. So I hope that you keep enjoying the videos, you keep seeing our site, and I hope that you gain more knowledge. Thank you very much.